Hello and welcome to Daily Roundup. I am Samedha, and on this episode of the Daily Roundup, we give you a glimpse of some of the most important stories that we report about at Newsclick. The Indian Air Force pilot, Abhinandan, who was in Pakistan's custody, will be handed over to India through the Wagah border. The Pakistan government has specified that the wing commander is being released as a gesture of peace. Imran Khan, the Pakistani Prime Minister, announced the release of the pilot at a joint session of the parliament, saying that this should be seen as the first step to open negotiations.
Hindustan ka pilot humne pakda hua hai. Hum as a peace gesture, hum unko usko kal riha karne lage hain Hindustan ko wapas.
Whereas there have been repeated attempts from the neighbouring country's Prime Minister to offer peace and to begin dialogue, both the countries have also witnessed the worst of media coverage in recent times. Following the Pulwama attack, the media in both the countries did not leave any stone unturned to create a warlike situation and to escalate the tensions among people. Hashtags such as revenge, Pakistan se badla, and other similar hashtags have been seen as trending on social media platforms. But even in this situation, a sensible section of the people from both sides came together to give a message of saying no to war. In one such instance, journalists from Lahore Press Club came out in the support of Abhinandan and asked the government to release the wing commander immediately. Contemporary Indian society is currently under what can be best termed as modern slavery. Over 50 crore workers who are actually bonded are still alive and thriving in India under a system which is oppressive and exploitative of their poverty and their pains. Today in Delhi, some of these workers came forward to give out their testimonies of how they were released and also saved from being trafficked into other states under exploitative conditions. These workers have been promised certain wages, were never even paid even half of those wages. The workers are then forced to live under the flyovers or to do begging in order to survive in the cities. Take a look at some of the testimonies that we found today.
Mara jamadar jo hai wo hame bhaka ke laya tha bhatte par Haryana mein. Hame 10,000 rupaye diye the usne. 4 mahine hamare kaam karwaya. Hamare bachcho ko khane ko kuch mila. Dukaan mein samaan anwaya tha deta tha. Hum mange hamari maar peet kar tha. 5 mere ladki hai, 2 bachche. मियां बीबी हम 9 आदमी अब हम देखो 4 महीने से की कर घुमा खा रहे क्या करें हम स्कूल में बच्चे हमारे जा रहे थे पहरा लगाता हमारे पर हमारी लड़की देखता वो पहरा लगाता बदाम की कर मजबूर आना पड़ा हमें फिर यहाँ
काले खासे इसने उठाया राजेश ठेकेदार ने तो इसने उठा के हम लोगों के यहाँ पे बोला कि 1,000 रुपया दूंगा वहाँ पे ले जाकर इसने 500 रुपए दिए 500 रुपए देकर फिर इसने 8 दिन की बोली कि हाँ 8 दिन में तुम लोगों को खर्चा दूंगा मैं इसने खर्चा कोई ना दिया है खर्चा खर्चा फिर इसने 8 दिन के बाद 10 दिन के बाद इसने 200 रुपए दिए हम लोगों को तो हम लोग में 200 रुपए में हमारे बच्चे हम लोग सारे जने यहाँ पे गुजारा चलाते रहे 8-10 दिन का 15 दिन का भी हम लोग कैसे रहे हो गए मजबूर
In the JNU sedition case, the Delhi High Court is going to proceed with or without any sanction. The Delhi court expressed displeasure over the Delhi police not being able to get the requisite sanctions in the well-known 2016 JNU sedition case. Metropolitan Magistrate Deepak Sheheravat was informed by the Delhi Police Council that the Delhi government has not yet given its approval to prosecute Kumar and others under the IPC Section 124A, which is the sedition charge. The Delhi Government's Council replied that it is still exploring legal angles on the issue. The Delhi police have charged the former JNU SU president Kanhaiya Kumar and JNU students Umar Khalid and Anirban Bhattacharya for allegedly shouting anti-India slogans during an event which was actually to mark the hanging of Parliament attack mastermind Afzal Guru. In international news, the Poor People's Campaign in the United States of America has announced a nationwide bus tour to highlight true emergencies in the states. The initiative will highlight the struggles and the emergencies afflicting the US's 140 million poor and low-income citizens. The tour will be launched in the month of March and will reach out to about 28 states. The tour is also being seen as a response to US President Donald Trump's declaration of state along the southern border. People's Campaign is an American anti-poverty campaign which demands federal and state living wage laws, equity in education, a single-payer healthcare system, and other demands too. Reverend Theo Harris, the founder of the group, said, and I quote, "Instead of tackling the real emergencies of systemic racism, poverty, militarism, and ecological devastation, the president is diverting funds to build a monument for white supremacy at our southern border." That's all that we have for you today on this episode of the Daily Roundup. To follow these stories and many more, log on to our website www.newsclick.in, subscribe to our channel on YouTube, and follow us on Facebook. Thank you for watching.